Hey guys, this is Mark. In this video, I'll be talking about a new feature we added to UI Builder, and that feature is support for themes. What is a theme? Well, it is a combination of styles that is applicable to the entire UI app built in Backendless. Every single component that you use in Backendless, and in the future that will be applicable to the custom components, are going to be subject to the way they are rendered with the styles defined in themes. There are some pre-built themes in Backendless, and very soon we will provide a way for you to create custom themes and publish it back to Backendless. What can you customize? Pretty much everything and anything that exists in the realm of the UI. That is applicable to individual screens and pages, margins, paddings, backgrounds, and the same thing for individual components. And as you will see, with the themes that we provided, components may look very different. And every single tiny detail that exists around every single component is customizable. Is this a no-code approach for themes? Not so much. I would say it's a low-code approach, because in order to create a theme or customize a theme, you need to know CSS or less. If you know less, all the power to you, because we support the entire suite of everything that less supports, and that includes variables, mixins, animations. Well, animations are supported with CSS as well, but anyway, so everything that less can do can be used in Backendless UI Builder now with themes. So on top of this, there is a new thing that we added, and that is support for app extensions. And I will demonstrate how app extensions work. And in a way, basically, when you apply a theme, you can customize that theme by adding individual extensions. And in those extensions, you can add your own CSS classes and assign them to individual components. So every single component now has a field where you can specify CSS classes. So with that, you can get to the point where the entire app can be customized to match the look and feel of your branding, or you know, whatever the designers came up with. And literally, you can actually make it pixel perfect, where the app created with UI Builder matches almost one-to-one the original design. So now I will switch to a demo to demonstrate how themes work, so you can actually see and appreciate how much this can be helpful for building a beautiful app with UI Builder in Backendless. Okay, so here I have a rather basic page, and let's just jump into themes and let me demonstrate how this would work. So one of the changes you will see is that there is now a tab. There used to be just user interface and logic. Now there is a tab called theme. If you go to this tab, you will see this user interface. Now these are themes available out of the box. Okay, you can extend it out, and well, this is not that significant, but if you want, I'm just going to see more of them. This list will be growing. We are adding our own themes, and very soon users will be able to create their themes and publish it back to the app. So in here, the page that you see, this is sort of a preview page. In fact, you see that there is a preview tab. This is a page that includes all the components that exist in Backendless, like all the core components. And then what happens is you can just click on a theme. And as you can see, I'm just clicking on different themes. And this page automatically re-rendered using that theme. If you'd like, you can actually pick any one of your pages. So for instance, I do have this page called Cards. And then here, as you can see, I can just switch between different themes. And that page is instantly previewed, so you can see what it looks like with any given theme. I'm going to go back to all components. And all components is a page that we pre-built just to make it easier for you to actually see what it looks like and apply your themes. How do you customize a theme, or how do you actually, well, before you customize, how do you apply that theme to your application? For every single theme, whenever one is selected, you'll see this install button. So once you click install, then that theme becomes current one. So in fact, if I go back to user interface, then you can see that the page that I had before, and if I pick any other page, like for instance, this is the default basic page, that theme is now applied. And changing theme is extremely simple. What you do is, if you go back to theme, just find another one. And as you can see, this one says applied. You can just pick any other one and apply it, and it will become the default theme for your application. All right. Customization. Customizations are actually very straightforward, but as I said, you need to understand CSS less in order to make those changes. In order to make changes, you need to make a local copy of that theme, because the themes that you see here, they're actually hosted in the cloud, so you would need to be able to make a local copy first, and then can start making changes to that theme. To make changes, you go to the editor tab, so click editor, and then the theme that we installed, well, the theme that you installed already becomes sort of local, so you can start making changes. So these are the customizations that came with that theme. However, these customizations sit on top of the entire CSS library of all kinds of settings and CSS classes and definitions that come with UI Builder. You can see that core definition just by going, whenever you are in the editor, you see this little icon, Open SDK Styles. If you click on this, then this is the core definition of everything style-wise that exists in Backendless. So it starts with some of the core variables that apply for the rest of your application. And then every single theme inherits everything that you see here, okay? And then in here, you will find definitions for every single component. So as you can see, there is block, chart, checkbox, buttons. Everything is going to be here. Do you need to modify this? No, this one is sort of constant. It cannot change. What you can do is whenever you create your own theme or customize an existing theme, in this case, we have this dark fire. This is the customization. So these customizations apply on top of these SDK styles, okay? So by applying these customizations, that's what changes the look and feel of your application, all right? So in here, so for instance, if we were to change the primary theme color, right now it's this color, let's change it to something else. And here there is another icon to open the color picker. And let's just pick some other color. It's going to be, let's say, some tone of green, like for instance this one. Not sure if it's going to look good or not, but let's make a copy. And in here, I will just paste it and comment out what was there before. All right, so this change was made. And now if I go back to the preview, now you see that this color of the outlines have changed. All right. Now, what if we want to change the app background? So this is the app background. Let's just pick some other color and let's go something like wild, some kind of off yellow right here. So this is going to be app background. I'll paste it and comment out what was there before. So go to preview and there you go. This app background, as you can see, has been modified. All right. So by making these changes, all right, so this is, let's say, panel background. Let's also modify panel background and then pick some, you know, something in this palette. All right. So panel background, paste it, comment out what was there before. Go to preview. And as you can see, we now got this wild, not very pleasant looking, but still this kind of gets the message across as to how you can customize it. All right. So this is the process that you can go through to make the changes that you need. All right. So I'm going to revert this back. What can you customize? Well, everything that you see in here in the core SDK styles, you can customize. So you can start customizing individual components. You can customize, you know, borders, text colors. As I said, everything can be customized because this gives you the definition of what exists in Backendless out of the box. All right. Now, on top of this, so this is the definition of the theme. On top of this, you can add extensions. All right. So extensions, if you go here, are essentially just files with CSS less definitions. And you can add new extensions. Just click this button and then give it a name, and that will create that extension. Why extensions are important? Well, you need to understand the following structure. So at the bottom of the hierarchy, we have this SDK styles, these guys, all right? On top of this, there is a definition of the theme. So this is the definition of the theme. And then on top of this, you get your extensions. All right. So these extensions, everything that you define here sits on top of the theme. Extensions are important when you want to customize your application and whatever changes you introduce. And let's say if you're not intending to publish that theme, your customizations, back into Backendless directory of themes, then extensions is the way to go. However, if you're planning to make changes to a theme in order to republish it back into our directory, then you would need to make changes directly in the theme. In other words, extensions are sitting on top of the theme and they're not part of it. However, whatever you put in the extensions directly applies to the entire UI container that includes all of your pages, all right? So that's essentially how it goes. In here, whenever you preview your pages, there is a checkbox to preview it with extensions or without extensions. And this kind of gives you a control of how to do it. Some examples of how to create extensions and then modify the behavior. In here, I do have the page that is called cards. And as you can see, whenever I move the mouse over, there is this animation happens and the image becomes blurry. So this is done with extensions that were added to the application. And specifically, if we go to theme and then go into extensions, in here, see this cards, and I'm going to open the editor. So this is the extension that makes this behavior where on the hover, there is here's the transform and there is a blur. So with these two, this is the behavior that we're going to get, all right? Exactly what you see right here. Now, the cool thing with extensions, let's say if I were to change the theme, this behavior will stay because, as I said, the extensions, they go on top of the theme, all right? So, in fact, let me just select this page right here, all right? So I can change the theme. This behavior will stay because extensions remain in place. Some other example that I have here, well, it's going to be called image flip. And in here, as you can see, this is also done with an extension. So in here, flip card, this is going to be the editor for the flip card. So in here defines the behavior for what you see right here. When the image can, or a card can be flipped and there is image on one side and text on the other side. So now this is part of Backendless. You can create these kind of animations. Anything that is supported by LESS is now supported within Backendless. And with this, you can get fantastic control for visualization and user experience of your application. I hope you found this useful. We'll definitely be publishing more information about themes and then what's supported in Backendless. And of course, very soon you will have an ability to create your own custom themes and publish them back into Backendless. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you found it useful. And as always, happy codeless coding.